Hey guys, in this video we'll see how to do unit testing in React. Let's run our React app. So this is our React app where we have a fading text, a normal text and a link. And if I click on this link, it launches a URL. So let's see how do we test this. Before we start writing tests, we need to make sure we have the dev dependencies installed. So the two dev dependencies needed are testing library React and React Test Renderer. After installing, you can see the dependencies inside your package.json dev dependencies section. Also guys, do note that the version of React Test Renderer should be the same as what you have of your React. So in our case, it's 17.0.2. So let's see how does our folder structure look like. On the left hand side, we can expand the components folder. So it has different components comprised under folders. For example, we have a text component in the text folder, link component in the link folder, fader component in the fader folder. Let's take a component, let's say text, and see what's inside this. So it basically comprises of a normal div with h3 and a parameter which is passed for this component is a text, and this text should be of type string. For writing tests for this component, we will be making use of Jest, and let's see what's Jest. So basically it's a JavaScript testing framework which works with projects like Babel, TypeScript, React and other popular UI frameworks. In the website itself, it claims to be fast and safe, provides code coverage, easy mocking, and also it's used by companies like Airbnb, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, etc. All our tests will be placed under this folder --test --, and inside this we will categorize them based on the components. So for example, the text folder will have the test for the text component, link folder will have the test for link component, and the fader will have the test for fader component. One thing to note is all the tests should be preceded by .test.js. So for example, we have link as link.test.js, fader as fader.test.js. This helps Jest to recognize that, hey, these files are for the test. Let's see our text test. So we click on this file and we also open the text component itself. First thing we do is import the testing library package. Next thing we import the Jest. For writing tests, we make use of this test which comes from Jest, and this takes basically a name, function and a timeout. So the name of our test is shouldRenderText component. The function comprises of the description of this test. In this test, we first render the text component using render. We use the screen.getByTestID and pass in the ID as text. This text ID is nothing but the test ID which we see in our text component, and this can be according to you. Screen is nothing but you can consider it as a DOM which comprises of the element which you just rendered. In our case, it holds the text component. Finally, we use the expect to see whether our element is present in the document. This expect function is basically used every time we want to test a value, and this to-be document, it sees whether an element is present in the document. Let's run this test now using the command npm test, and it runs our text.test.js. It says us, hey, you have one test suite, which is correct since we are in the text.test and it only has one test which is passed. Let's look at another component which is fader. So this comprises of a hook which is useState and useEffect. It comprises of props like text, and by default the text is set to hello world. So let's see how we can test this. So on the left hand side we have our fader test, which does is firstly render the fader component. We again use the screen.getByTestID to get that component, and the ID passed is fader. This ID is the same inside our fader component, which is also fader. Now we expect this element to be in the document. Next thing, it should have the text content as test. since we are passing the text as test once we render. Finally, we expect this element to have the CSS class as fade in, and if we see in the component, the first CSS class is fade in. Let's run the test now, and we see here the test suit is fader, which is correct. It has one test in it and it passes. For running all the tests in your project, you simply need to press A, and it comprises of three test suits now, total 4 tests, which everything is passed. We can also do snapshot testing using Jest, and snapshot testing is basically where a test case renders a UI component, takes a snapshot, and then compares it to the reference snapshot. Going back to our text components test, we open this file and we now have a snapshot test case. Let's see. First, we import the library React Test Renderer and render from that specifically. Next, we render our text component using renderer.create. Next, we call the toJSON method on the result of the renderer create. Finally, we expect the result to match the snapshot. This toMatch snapshot basically ensures the value matches the most recent snapshot. Once we run this test now, we see that, hey, this creates a folder called as snapshots, inside which it creates a snapshot of the text component. On clicking of the snapshot, we see that this is a normal file which comprises of the text component snapshot when this test was written. Now let's say someone from our team alters this test and enters a different value. So for example, let's say we take any value, let's say yo, and we close in the text. So if we see carefully, that snapshot comprises of the hey world, and now we have changed the text to be yo. Now if we run this test, this should fail since our snapshot won't match. And yes, it does. If we see the difference, it says that hey, the text is not matching, so it is having yo. Instead, the snapshot was having hey world. So in this case, if you want, you can update the snapshot using you, or you can correct your text. So let's see if we update the snapshot. So it runs the test again, and now it has updated the snapshot. If we can see here, it has yo, and also this test passes. That's it from this video, guys. If you like this video, share, subscribe, and comment.